Hey, this is Ree here. Thank you so much for joining me. I appreciate all of you. All thanks to Kali Ma. Thank you so much for liking and subscribing. It really helps me a lot. Don't forget to check out my website, paradoxastrology.com. Book your consultation today. I can help you with anything. And if you would like more exclusive occult videos that I don't post on YouTube, consider subscribing to my Patreon. It also helps to support this channel. Okay, let's get into this video. Long anticipated video about the eclipse happening on April 8th. I wanted to put this out a little bit earlier, but I had a lot of videos to put out before this, so here we go. This is a very special eclipse because on April 9th, we have a very important day which is celebrated in Hinduism and Sanatan Dharma. It's called Chaitra Navratri. This always happens on the first day of the lunisolar calendar. So it will be celebrated from April 9th to April 17th. So it's very auspicious. And during this time, we worship Goddess Durga and all of the forms of Goddess Durga. And then on the last day, people celebrate Ram Navami, which is another very auspicious Hindu holiday. So the worship of the goddesses is very essential in Hinduism, in Sanatan Dharma, and in tantric practice as well, for spiritual growth. So that being said, this being close to the eclipses, this is very auspicious because it kind of gives it a lot more energy. The effects of the sadhana, of the rituals that we do, or the mantras or the meditation, whatever you choose to do, it is essentially amplified, some say 1,000 times. So if you want to advance spiritually, this is a very important time for you to be doing your spiritual practice, whatever that may be for you. You don't have to necessarily do the rituals or anything like that, but just do your normal meditation, what you do, and it will amplify, especially because of the eclipses. What is meant by that, the spiritual awakening, is when we awaken ourselves by doing the practices, it awakens parts in our brain. This is what the goddesses equal all of our chakras. So then it awakens the center in the brain that were dormant. And this is essentially how we evolve. This is the evolution of man, which is what Neuralink is trying to replicate, but could never reproduce. You don't need to get a chip in your head, you just need to understand how to do certain practices, certain mantras. So you could do the mantra to Goddess Durga if you wanted to, and that will help you a lot. Also, this chart is very important because it is the chart for the new year, because the new year starts when the new moon is in Pisces. This eclipse is in Revati Nakshatra, which is the symbol of the fish, and the fish in the sea, which represents our soul's journey in the waters of the universe. So with Rahu here, this is where we are headed as a society, and this is our destiny. This is our karma in the year of Saturn, the year of karma. This is where we're going to go for the next 9 years until K2 ends up in Revati or in Pisces again. So what is your goal in this physical world? Where are you going? Who are you really? Who are you beyond your occupation, beyond your title of mom, dad, brother, sister, husband, or mechanic, or police officer, beyond your occupation, beyond your sex, beyond your race, beyond your gender? What are you beyond these things? Because all of these titles will end when you die, but you're not dead because you're going to reincarnate into another life with all new titles. So these titles are not actually you. What this wants you to do is to figure out who you really are beyond the character that you play in this physical reality, in this incarnation. This is who you're playing, but who are you really beyond the character? The more you figure out who you are, the more confidence you're going to gain in yourself. And who you are truly is not defined by your attachments in this mundane life. This is a path to liberation. This is the duality that we create when we put these titles on ourselves that separates us from each other. The bigger picture is to understand who we are as a collective consciousness. We are all reflections of God, and we must put back these pieces like the puzzle that we all are one. We are all that is, but it's an illusion. It's the Maya that convinces us that we are separate and makes us fight amongst each other like children. This is ignorance. So this is what this nakshatra is going to be asking you, what this year is going to be asking you. Pushan is the solar deity of this nakshatra that will light the path, like a lighthouse that guides us with the boats in the ocean. He is the inner light of the soul. Once awakened, gives us the eye the third eye, to see. It illuminates us from the dark and allows for spiritual enlightenment, spiritual growth, kundalini awakenings, which put us in touch with who we truly are, the Godhead. He stands in the beginning of all paths. This is the beginning marked by the eclipse, where we can transform for good. Wealth and prosperity come to us after the completion of this journey. After all, rivity means wealth, and wisdom is what brings us true wealth. He is the shepherd that guides us back to the flock. An example of how he guides us on our path is like in 2005 when we had the eclipses in the same position. So you can think back to like what were the events of 2005. The same themes will pop up this year and you can make different decisions now. On April 8, 2005, this is when Google Maps was launched, which changed the way we travel forever. More technology like this will be on the way and more advancements will emerge and more advancements in space travel and space itself. And there's a lot of scams going on with space, but I'll just let that be. So it's showing us our path, and that's literally Google Maps showing us our path. So more things like that. So it can be literal or metaphysical. Pushan has a lot to do with lights. This is street lights, and this is the light that lights you physically as well, not just metaphorically. And Rahu is electricity. So many movies have come up recently talking about power outages, electric vehicles breaking down. Mercury is also in retrograde, so many will be rethinking electric cars, and power outages are very likely, and problems with communication. I have a whole video on Mercury retrograde, and you can check out my video on my predictions for April, where I kind of go more into that as well. I'm just trying not to repeat what I've said in previous videos. Now, with K2 and Virgo, we're leaving the traditional occupations as they may be taken over by new technology, and many layoffs will come for this year, and those working with their hands in trades in the entertainment industry as new tech and AI emerge. Jobs that are related to transport may be affected, and some may have to go overseas to foreign lands. Like the Baltimore crash, where the boat crashed into the bridge in the US, we have to be cautious of boats and electricity, accidents in water, chemical spills, emergencies with ways of transport, and unexpected events in these areas. Mass destruction, like hurricanes, are very likely this year because this is the anniversary of Hurricane Katrina. Transiting K2 is conjunct the US natal Saturn right now in the 10th house, which was a catalyst for the event in 2005. When Saturn and K2 come together, it's a loss for the country. And this eclipse will be visible all through the US. In September 2005 was the largest evacuation in Houston, which took place as millions evacuated for Hurricane Katrina. So I'm just going to show you the map really quickly of where this will be visible. And these are the areas that will have the most events occur, even though it will affect everybody. Now, Hurricane Rita was the most intense of tropical storms on record in the Gulf of Mexico, and it was the fourth most intense Atlantic hurricanes has been ever recorded. So 2005 was a year of record-breaking hurricane season in the Atlantic. So we have to really be cautious of that because Rahu in Pisces, right? Pisces is water and Rahu is just unexpected and just amplifies that and wants to do records. So there was also Hurricane Wilma as well. Very big, massive hurricanes. And also earthquakes are very possible. Always happens around the eclipse time. There could possibly be one in Pakistan in the Kashmir region as well, because there was a record-breaking one then in 2005, so we must be careful around that area. These things tend to reoccur. The price of gas may go up, but fear not, this nakshatra is all about faith and optimism and seeing the glass half full. So it's also very important to stay grounded. With Rahu and Venus here, there could also be a lot of cheaters, a lot of fraud, romance scams, charities lacking integrity, trying to scam people. And this could bring a sense of deluded fantasies in our lives where we can be led astray. So we have to be careful of that. People dipping their toes outside of marriage is very possible, thinking that this is the answer because Rahu here creates desire and greed. K2 in the seventh house can create separations in relationships, divorces, especially when Saturn and Mars conjunct in the 12th house, which is aspecting K2 during this eclipse. These are hidden conflicts, things that we did not see coming. Bed pleasures and its aspecting Jupiter in the second house, which can involve family matters as well. This nakshatra can make you believe things that aren't necessarily true. So at the same time, it's really important to have discernment. It's important to see things the way they are and to see through the illusion so that we don't get off of our path, because it's about finding our path. This is ruled by Mercury, which is in retrograde at the Gandhanta point, and this is a point of challenge. This nakshatra is ruled by the drum, which announces the news. So what is communicated to us must be processed with knowledge and logic, and not emotion, as many will try to play on your emotions to sway you in a certain direction, or your own emotions can sway you in the wrong direction as well. Prostitution and human trafficking will be themes that will be exposed. This is isolated places, imprisonment, and those in entertainment. The reality will come when Saturn moves in Purva Bhadrapada on April 6th, and it will already do that by the time I put this video out. And that is ruled by Jupiter. So this will cause a mass awakening for many throughout the year. The celebrities, the gurus, the authority figures that you thought you knew end up being two-faced. They had dark secrets. They had secret lives. They were not who they said they were. This is also highlighted as the moon is the fifth house lord of entertainment and athletes, and the third house lord and eighth house lord. Third house is communication, and eighth is transformation and death, which is Venus, will be in the first house as well, exalted. And this is why we don't use celebrity charts, and you will see why I say that this year. Purva Bhadrapada is the nakshatra of black magic. So what is black magic? It's the ability to persuade or overtake the mind of an individual. Who does this better than a celebrity or the dark elite or the ruling elite? Why do you think NASA is launching on this day, and also the CERN Collider is launching on this day? It's a ritual for the dark elite. This is the perfect nakshatra to do this in. Black magic uses the asuras, which are demons and dark entities. And what is Rahu? A demon. So there's going to be an emphasis during this year on refinement, sophistication, grooming, civilized behavior, especially because Jupiter is going to enter Venus in May as well, and that will amplify Venus behavior. But Rahu may overtake this for some, so many will be acting very animalistic, unlogical, egotistical, emotional, and some may bring back conservative and traditional values, which we're already seeing happening now. Crime and overdoses will be rampant, and problems with immigration, drugs, and imprisonment, like I mentioned. This nakshatra and Pisces is transcending the world, whether that be with psychedelics, spirituality, awakenings, kundalini, and Rahu here is also AI, which is creating a new world, like technology, like, say, the metaverse or Neuralink, which in turn will take people to another side, another reality, but that's not what people will think it is. Rivati is ruled by Mercury, and Mercury will be at the Gandhanta point in retrograde in Ashwini. Ashwini is ruled by the divine celestial healers. Aries is something new that may pop up in health, and this is transport, this is athletes, this is buildings, engineering, structures that may collapse. And this is also gambling in all kinds of business activities on the material plane and all the planes of existence. Trade and wealth can be affected, or we may have to redo some of these things. When I talk about trade, I'm saying that because on April 19th, 1987 was known as Black Monday, but also known as Black Tuesday, depending on what part of the world you were in. And this is when we saw the largest stock market crash happen. Worldwide losses were estimated at $1.71 trillion. This was when Rahu was in Pisces, but in Uttara Bhadrapada. And that won't happen till the end of the year, but it should be noted because it could happen earlier. We have the eclipse happening in that nakshatra, I think, around October, but just to be cautious. Now, Jupiter is in Kritika, is related to cutting, and in the second house, that there could be some new cuts to financial conditions of the country. Budgeting is expected. Ego clashes in relationships or families may happen because a person is too critical or too aggressive. Be careful of your speech as well. This shows that many will be seeking the knowledge of the sages, higher level knowledge. This could be due to jobs loss, where people go back to school or go to school for the first time. Or this could be an awakening where some just want to know more about ourselves and the universe. Some may go back to university. Many will spend money on counselors for spiritual matters. Many will be criticizing gurus in the entertainment industry. Many will receive money for childcare and education, and more money will be put in the pockets of families. But we have to be careful because this nakshatra is all about adulterous nature, illicit affairs. It's about surrogacy, foster parenting, and illegitimate and abandoned children. We can expect a lot of forest fires this summer as Jupiter will be in Kritika, and that is ruled by Agni, the god of fire. Now, because we have Saturn, Mars conjunction in the 12th house of losses and endings, the second house lord is conjunct the 12th house lord, and Mars is aspecting Ketu, which can cause it the worst of terrorist attacks, fires, accidents, and death. But on a positive note, this could be money obtained from spiritual practices, so you can be attracting this from spiritual practice or from a spiritual business. So businesses like astrology and tarot, psychic healers will be in demand. Saturn will also be an Ashwini in the D9, and this can cause an explosive temper in some, impatience when looking for results, trying to do shortcuts in the wrong ways, and nefarious ways that may be cruel and that may hurt others. This can also bring karma to those physicians who were deliberately hurting their patients. Aquarius is the masses, society, and social affairs, which is where this conjunction is happening. And it's also rebellion. So with Mars and Saturn conjunction aspecting Ketu, this can show the masses rebelling. That can lead to violence or death. This could also be strikes as well. Saturn here is showing someone who is two-faced. Saturn is civil servant, and Mars is a soldier and the general and the military. So the police may also be involved. And this aspect of Ketu, like I said, is a terrorist attack at the worst. Purva Bhadrapada Nakshatra is all about death. It's the front part of the funeral cot. It's our exit from this world. So some people will be exiting also due to health matters, which I'll talk about. The health matter is because this is a similar eclipse that happened in 2005, April 8th, 2005. It was very, very similar placements because we had Mercury and Venus in there as well. In January 2005, there was a outbreak of the bird flu. And I'm already seeing this happening. I mentioned this in my video before in the April predictions, and they're already trying to scare people and say that it's going to be worse than COVID was. Don't let people scare you or anything like that. A lot of these things are pre-planned on the masses. And I won't say any more about that because that's not what this video is about. But we could see that happening, and that ended up being a worldwide event. And they ended up killing a lot of birds because of this, which is very sad. They said that the influenza could have killed 5 to 150 million people. That's what they said. It spread basically all over the world. So we have to be very cautious because also Jupiter is going to be entering the sixth house of the US chart. And this is health issues. It could expand health issues. It could expand war and strikes and things like that. Enemies as well. Also, the sixth house lord is here, which is Sun in the first house of this eclipse. And Ketu is in Virgo, which is all about health. And Pisces is hospitalization. I have a video about Saturn, Purva Bhadrapada, and I explained what kind of things like cancer and other things, and in my Mercury one as well, what kind of problems we'll see in health matters. I also mentioned this in a previous video that on April 14, 2005, there was the Israel-Palestine conflict, and there was another conflict that was carried out, ended up being very gruesome. So there is a strong possibility that that happens again just because of what's happening now. Because on April 8th, the Saturn-Mars conjunction will be conjunct Palestine's Rahu in the 7th house. And this could be an open enemy attack on the homeland. And a lot of this was triggered by the eclipse on the 25th as well. And on the 8th, it will affect Israel as well because Ketu is in its first house and Rahu is in its seventh house. So these eclipses will greatly impact how the world sees Israel and its alliances this year. So that's just a little bit of what I see. I thank you so much for watching. I appreciate all of you, and I'll see you in the next one.